Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about how the ionic bond is been formed between the two atoms as well as the covalent bond. But in that case we have taken a help of the Lewis structure. So what is actually Lewis structure? Let us talk about it. So Lewis structure is actually a representation of the atom's valence electron, and whenever they form a molecule, so we always represent the number of total number of electrons or the total number of valence electrons representing the valence electron of a particular atom, and that is how we can get the overall electrons that are being present in a molecule. But meanwhile, in that case, only few or sometimes all the atoms, they can be form a bond representing a bond, or in that case only few of the electrons, they represent the formation of a bond. So that is what we are going to learn about. That is how to represent the Lewis structure of it, and what is the kind of representation that we are going to do. So let us talk about this one in the following one. That is, the Lewis dot structure can be written by using the following steps. And usually what we do is we represent the structure or the Lewis structure of that particular molecule by representing the dots, and this dots actually represents the valence electron of that particular atom. And let us talk about it, each of it one by one, and then we will be able to know exactly how the Lewis structure has been drawn, or we could say that is how it has been represented. So talking about the first one, that is, the valence electrons of the combining atoms are added to get the total number of electrons for writing the Lewis dot structure of a particular molecule. So suppose if I am talking about this one, like H2O, so suppose if I have to represent the total number of electrons that are being in the overall molecule, and only if we have to focus on the valence electrons. So therefore oxygen is the one which consists of basically 6 electron in its outermost shell or as a valency. So therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 electron in its outermost shell. And while talking about the hydrogen has only 1 electron in its outermost shell, or as a valence electron. So therefore this is 1, and again it is 1. So therefore these are the total number of electrons or total number of valence electrons that represents about a molecule that it covers with. So that is what, and talking about the thing that I have talked about earlier only, that is, it is not necessary that all the electrons, they will be forming a bond. Only few of them can also form a bond. So hydrogen give its electron or in the formation of that is a bond between hydrogen and oxygen. And here also the formation of a bond takes place between oxygen and hydrogen. But meanwhile, these two electrons, they don't take part in the formation of a bond. So that is what I was giving a small glimpse about what is actually Lewis structure and what does it represents. So the first point is very much clear, and that is what we have got to do. And now let us talk about the next one. That is, so the second point is basically the removal of one electron is one positive charge on the molecule, while the addition of one electron is one negative charge on the molecule. So let me explain this. Suppose if we are representing, that is, NH4+. So since I have represented 1+ over here, this indicates that one electron has been removed from that molecule, and that is how we represent the plus charge. So, and while talking about, that is, SO4-, we represent it by SO42-. So this 2- or this negative charge, this indicates that the two electrons has been added in the overall molecule or in this overall group, and that is the reason it has attained a 2 negative charge over here. And this is what we are going to represent it while drawing the Lewis structure. So this is not exactly the Lewis structure, but meanwhile we will talk about it later on, and let us see that how can we represent it in the following steps if we follow that one. So this is the third one that I'm going to talk about. That is the third point. That is, the skeletal structure of the molecule is written as symbol of atoms. We always represent the symbol of atoms, and the number of valence electrons which are distributed as bonding shared pair electrons. So obviously we represent the Lewis structure in such a way that the atomic symbols of the element has been represented along with that of the valence electron. And obviously whenever so as to form a bond between the two atoms, obviously there will be shared pair of electrons that will be between the two atoms, and that is how it has been represented. So for example, if I want to represent like that of the previous example that I have took over here, that is, if you want to make an example to showcase that what is actually Lewis structure between the two atoms, or the bond that forms between the two atoms, so I would represent it this way. For example, I'm talking about like H2. So oxygen is what I've written over here, and it consists of basically 6 electrons. So therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons is of oxygen. While talking about the hydrogen, so hydrogen has basically 1 electron. So here also hydrogen has suppose 1 electron. So obviously these electrons are basically shared between the two atoms over here, and that is how a bond forms takes place. But we don't represent bond over here because we are representing the Lewis structure, or we could say it's Lewis dot structure. So we don't have to represent a bond, but even this could be written as in this form, that is Lewis dash form. Actually this is the Lewis dot structure. While talking about this one is basically Lewis bond or Lewis dash structure. So not only it represents the lone pair of electron, but it also represents the bond, and that is what these are the two differences. But now we are going to represent only, we are talking about Lewis dot structure. So therefore this is the Lewis dot structure that we have, and because of the shared pair electrons that are being between the two, that is oxygen and hydrogen, and again oxygen and hydrogen. So this is the third point that I was talking about. So therefore this is the skeletal structure of a molecule as an example. So talking about the next one, that is the atom which is least electronegative is written at the central position of the molecule. So whenever we write a Lewis structure, or whenever we represent a particular molecule which has less electronegative in the overall molecule, a particular atom which is less electronegative in the overall molecule, then we always try to represent it on the left hand side, and that is how we are going to write it. Suppose if I'm talking about CO3 2 minus, so this is what I am going to represent. So obviously we write actually that is the more the less electronegative on the left hand side, while the more electronegative is on the right hand side. So this is how we represent, and this 2 minus 8 indicates that there is an addition of 2 electrons over here. And while drawing the structure of this, I could make the structure in this way also. Suppose this is how I'm representing the Lewis dot structure of this carbonate ion that I have. So this is the structure what I'm going to represent, and it consists of this carbon consists of, obviously we know that the valence electron of the carbon is basically 4, and this is how it is represented. So therefore I would represent it in this way, that is 1 2 3 4. So this is the valence electron of the carbon that I have been mentioned over here. And talking about the oxygen, so this is the oxygen that we have, and I'm representing it in this way. And again, oxygen has basically 6 electrons in its outermost shell. So therefore, I'm representing in this way. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is, I would write it over here as 6, 7. So suppose if in this case, and again, the another oxygen, again, it will have 6 electrons. So I would represent over here in this way. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is 5 and 6. Again, I can represent in this way. And another oxygen that we have, so this is the oxygen that we have, again it consists of that is 6 electrons in the outermost shell. So 1 2 3 4 5 6. So this is what I have represented over here. But talking about the charge, and let me explain about the charge. So in this case, suppose if I am talking about in this way, that is the carbon is the one that has to form two bonds over here. So that is the two bonds that are been formed between this carbon and this oxygen. Talking about this one, this will form basically one bond between this carbon and this oxygen. Again, this one will form, that is one bond between this oxygen and this carbon. So now talking about the charge, that is this 2 minus, suppose this is what I want to represent. So suppose if I have made a charge over here, that is an electron over here, so therefore there will be a formation of one bond. So this is how I have included, or I have added an extra electron to this one. So that's the reason that the one extra electron has been added, and moreover, suppose if I'm adding it over here like this one, so again an extra electron has been added. So therefore the overall structure will have basically 2 extra electrons, and that is the reason that is how I represent it with 2 minus charge. So therefore this is the structure, the Lewis dot structure that we represent for this ion that we have represented over here. So similarly we can do the various things also, so as to represent the that is a Lewis structure of the other molecules. So this one is clear, and as we have discussed, obviously there will be a formation of one bond over here, and as you could see here, that is the oxygen which forms or which has a valence electron, that is 1 2 3 4 that is 5 6 7 And now, because of this, it will have basically an 8 electrons. So this is how it has. And but meanwhile, it will have one extra charge also, because there will be our extra charge, that is minus 1. Again, here it will be an extra electron. So minus 2 charge will be there. So because of the addition of electrons from somewhere, I suppose if I am talking about like hydrogen. So originally it is basically H2CO3. But now because of oxygen, which is more electronegative, so obviously the hydrogen will be expelled in like H plus, while the electron of the hydrogen will be remain with that of the oxygen, and that is how the bond will form over here, and that's it. And now let me talk about the another one, that is how can we represent the Lewis structure for Lewis dot structure for NF3. So suppose this is what I have to represent, and let us talk about this one. So in this example also, where we have represented the most least electronegative atom in the molecule, that is carbon, and that was written in the central of the overall molecule. So meanwhile, here also we can say that the one which is least electronegative, that is represented at the extreme left, and while drawing the Lewis structure, it should be at the center. So that's the reason that the nitrogen will be at the center. But meanwhile, talking about that, what would be the Lewis structure of the particular nitrogen? But for that, we should know that is the electronic configuration of nitrogen, that is it could be represented as nitrogen 7, that is it represents the number of electrons that are present in the nitrogen or the atomic number. So that could be written as 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So this represents that there are total five electrons that are present in the outermost shell of the nitrogen, and that's the reason that we could represent the structure of nitrogen in this way, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five electrons that are present in the outermost shell of the nitrogen. By talking about the fluorine is the one which is having an atomic number of 9. So that could be represented as 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. So the outermost shell consists of that is 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So therefore, I could write it in this way. That is, I'm talking about fluorine. So therefore, fluorine could be represented in this way. That is, fluorine has 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So therefore, this is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. So there are 7 electrons in its outermost shell, and this is what the Lewis structure of fluorine can be written as. But here we need basically 3 fluorine atoms so as to form a complete molecule, and that is the reason that we will represent it in this way, which consists of 1 nitrogen and 3 fluorines. So I'm representing it here, and this is how, that is, it consists of, the nitrogen consists of 5 electrons in its outermost shell. So that is the reason that it will have 5 electrons in its outermost shell, and it will form a bond between 3 fluorine atoms, and that is what I am representing over here. So the fluorine atom, that is what I am representing, that could be written in this format. That is, it consists of 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So this is the first one, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. By talking about the another fluorine, so similarly we can represent it for other 3. And this is what I am going to represent. So this is the Lewis structure of this one. And talking about this thing, that is this black dot, actually I have represented for the fluorine, and this red dot, it represents the electron of the nitrogen. So therefore, this 2 electrons are being shared between the fluorine and nitrogen, and that is the reason that one bond would be formed over here. And talking about the another one, that is I forgot to represent this one. So talking about the another, here also there will be formation of one bond, and here also there will be formation of one bond. So therefore, this is the Lewis structure that we have, Lewis dot structure that we have represented for the NF3 molecule. And here we have not represented any kind of bond, but this 2 electrons that we could see, it suggests that there is a presence of one bond over here. And this 2 electrons of the nitrogen, they are not combined with any kind of atom, and that is basically remained as a lone pair of electron. So this is how we have represented the structure in this way, and making the nitrogen to be the least electronegative, that is being represented in the central of the overall molecule, and that is how we can also represent it in a bond structure or dash structure of the NF3. So it is possible. So now let us move on with the next point that we have, and let us talk about the next point. So after writing the number of electrons as shared pair forming single bonds, or the remaining electron are being used as either the multiple bonds or for lone pair of electrons. So this is what I am representing the structure over here. So similarly, that what we have got to know, that is this represents the shared pair of electrons that are being shared between these 2 atoms, Meanwhile, if I am talking about these two electrons, so these two electrons or the remaining electron that are being left, not only in for nitrogen but for the fluorine atom also. So these electrons that are being basically that are being not forming a bond or that has not forming an interaction between these two atoms. So therefore, this will remain as either they could be the lone pair of electrons or they could be unpaired electrons, or we could also say it as they will not be sharing their electrons with the other atom. So that is the reason only one bond has been formed over here, and that is what we are going to represent it in this way. So this is the structure I am drawing over here, just as to indicate that the leftover electrons are basically have no role in the formation of a bond, and this is what the Lewis bond structure is, or dash structure we could call them out. So this is the structure that we have, and let me give you another example also, that is whenever we write the structure of that is NO2 minus. So this is the structure that I have to write of NO2 minus. So how can we represent the structure of it? So obviously, since we have written the nitrogen, and the nitrogen is the one which is least less electronegative compared to that of the oxygen, so therefore it would be represented in, at the central. So therefore this is the central atom of the overall molecule, and it consists of basically 5 electrons. So therefore this is 5 electrons for the nitrogen. And obviously there will be formation of the bond between oxygen and again oxygen. So therefore I am representing it here. So oxygen consists of 6 lone pair of electrons. So therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the structure of electron that I have made for Lewis structure of the oxygen. And similarly, again one oxygen is being involved over here. So therefore I will represent over here as this one. So therefore this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and I could represent it with another electron, that is 6. But we have one electron here more, and obviously that this 2 electrons is of nitrogen, they will be able to form, that is 2 bonds over here, and meanwhile this there will be only one bond that will be formed over here. But talking about the oxygen consists of 6 electrons that is in its outermost shell. So let me represent it with the help of this one, that is, suppose if I have to represent the overall charge over here, and that is -1. So therefore there is -1 charge over here, which means there is an extra electron that is present in the overall molecule. So this electron and this electron, they will form a single bond, while this electron and this electron, they will form again a single bond. So ultimately there will be a double bond that will be formed over here, and this electron and this electron, they will form a single bond. So meanwhile this electron has been remaining, and this is basically for oxygen. So therefore this negative charge indicates that is there is presence of another electron, and that is between. So this is the electron that are being left out. So this is the charge of the nitrogen that we could represent. So moreover, we could write the structure in this way also, that is the nitrogen which forms, that is 2 bonds over here in this way, a single bond over here in this way, and which consists of, that is, an extra electron. So therefore I could represent with -1. So or else I could represent in this way, that is oxygen which is forming a double bond with the nitrogen and another which is forming one bond, and again -1. So this is a structure that I could draw of what the Lewis structure of NO2 minus. So that is, friend, that is what I want to talk about. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got an idea, that is, how can we represent the Lewis structure for various molecules, ions, or a kind of atom. So share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.